Ladies and gentlemen, can I welcome you to St John's on this very sunny afternoon, and particularly to the pre-prep celebration. Whether you're a parent, a grandparent, a family friend, or anyone else who knows the boys at St John's, I hope you'll join us in showing how proud we are of everything they've achieved this year. I hope they never experience another school year like this with so many challenges, but I have to say, we could not be more proud of everything that they have achieved. The academic work they've done, the friends they've made, the help and support that they've given each other, and the fact that they have grown up so incredibly well. I hope you enjoy seeing the video that we've prepared for you, which celebrates some of the boys' year, and even more so, we're looking forward to you joining us for the festival in a week's time. I did also want to thank Mrs. Powell Harper and all of the pre-prep team for all of the tremendous work they've done during the course of this year. When your son comes home, he'll be bringing with him a certificate, and that certificate represents one of the pairs of words from the Jesuit pupil profile. The Jesuit pupil profile is something that we use as a pastoral and an academic tool throughout the school to support the boys in their growth as human beings. Their academic achievements are obviously incredibly important, but they have to have a receptacle in which to achieve and to go and do amazing things in their life. Yes, we want them to be fantastic mathematicians and amazing writers and musicians and actors, but more than that, I want them to be compassionate people. I want them to be compassionate young men who see opportunities, who make opportunities, and do something innovative and ultimately outstanding with their lives that affects the lives of other people. So when they are coming home with their certificate, these are the first steps in them developing the skills that are going to be so important when they grow up into the young men we know they're going to be. Thank you for joining us again for this, and we hope you enjoy this video.
I have no moon. I am Mercury. I am Venus. I'm the same size as the Earth, but I spin the other way much more slowly. I have no water. I am Venus. Titan is my biggest moon. my big mirror top side for me. I'm very cold. I'm beautiful. Special kids. I am Wolf Dog One and I'm 4 years in the earth.
Apollo, and I'm going to the moon.
I'm Atlantis and I'm going to the earth.
And I'm Leo and I was the first shuttle in space.
I'm Flyshot.
Welcome to our end of year celebration. We'd like to share with you some of the amazing things we've learned and discovered over the past year.
When we all arrived in reception class, we did not think it was going to be so busy.
Wow! How wrong were we?
Let us start our autumn term.
It's going to be back with all our friends.
We have been taught how important it is to know our numbers and count, to help us when we go shopping and sharing out snacks and playing games.
We were shown how to work with shapes and build by tessellation, just in case we decided to be architects or builders, mathematicians or designers.
We have also been taught the importance of the environment around us. We look for bugs and beetles. We help us feed our birds and animals.
We discovered how swallows and other birds migrate to warm countries when the weather gets cold. Other birds and animals hibernate when it gets cold.
We worked really hard to write our letters in cursive. This will help us as we move and grow into middle or upper school to write our essays. Postcards for friends and family.
Mrs. Bill Harper always tells us, or make us stand out from the sound, to be able to handwrite a postcard, not email text.
Then there was our activity play with real donkeys. This was so much fun with everyone in pre-prep.
January and the springtime came. Sadly, we could not return to school. So we dusted our iPads and laptops and set to work at our kitchen tables.
We still managed to our science lessons, making extras freezing, and learned about dinosaur bones and fossils and became paleontologists.
We enjoyed dance to scream and learning our phonics and finally able to be back to school.
Yippee!
Just remember to open up the stairs, 'cause you
summertime began with us all learning a life cycle of a frog. We learned the words amphibian, meaning two lives, and metamorphosis, meaning a complete change.
Decorative arts and science. Science class, we made our own frog spawn out of jelly, raisins, and a chocolate frog. It tasted yummy.
In history, we have learned about Monte Castle and the battle facing in 1066.
It was great to start our weekly swim lessons again.
We made the most of our weekly PE lessons to keep us fit and healthy too.
Only George Forrest. We made Montebelli castles, clocked the 16 tricks and corrected our own rivers.
Section class been fun, cycling, but most of all, happy and kind place to be.
Thank you for coming to our assembly and letting us share our adventures from the past year.
Please put our hands together for our prayer.
Thank you, Lord, for keeping us safe and happy this year.
For the lessons we've learned online, at home and at school.
Keep us safe on the holiday and for the next school year ahead.
Amen. In the name of the Father, the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
This year in history, we've been looking at the ancient Egyptians.
The ancient Egyptians lived many thousands of years ago.
The ancient Egyptians are famous for many things.
Probably the most famous things, the pyramids.
The pyramid was a huge tomb for kings of Egypt.
The king of Egyptians was called the Pharaoh. The Pharaoh could order his pyramid as soon as he became king.
So how's my pyramid going?
Fine. We've got 400 or so people building it right now, so it shouldn't be too long.
Really? So how long do you think it's going to take?
Probably about 20 years.
20 years? Are you kidding?
No, we're doing really well. Well, more about 19.
19 years?
Before a pharaoh was put into his pyramid, of course he had to be dead.
The Egyptians had a special way of looking after the dead. They mummified them.
This was a way of preserving the body so it stays lifelike.
They wrapped them in strips of linen.
This is how they did it.
Today, I'm going to show you how to mummify the body. The first thing you do is go and check the body is dead.
Are you dead?
Yes. Great. Let's get started then. First we wash the body with scented palm wine.
Then we wash it off with water from the Nile.
The Nile is the river that runs through the whole of Egypt and was very important to Egyptians.
It was so important they treated the river Nile as a living thing.
They used it to grow all their crops and supply water for the hot weathers.
Now your body is ready for the next bit. You have to get all the organs out of the body.
Don't throw them away because we need them later.
Wait, you're going to do what?
We will sometimes put back into the body later or left inside the tomb in their jars.
Right, now we leave the body 40 days.
40 days later. Then all you have to do is wrap your body in strips of linen and your body's ready to pop into its tomb.
The whole process was usually so expensive that only the rich could afford it.
The ancient Egyptians believed in many gods. You can see pictures of the gods in hieroglyphics the ancient Egyptians left behind.
Some had human bodies and animal and bird heads.
My name is Bass. I am a dwarf with large features. My job is to look after babies and mummies I also protect against scorpion bites and nightmares.
My name is Ra, the sun god. I'm a human with a falcon head. My crown is surrounded by the sacred cobra, which is a sign of royalty and authority.
Hello, my name is Ross, and I am the golden British and hieroglyphs, and I can help people with a battle.
Aurora gods, Egyptians believed cats were sacred. One of the most famous pharaohs was Tutankhamun.
After years of searching, Carter couldn't find the tomb until Lord Caneron finally lost his patience.
Carter, you're probably the best apprentice I've ever had, but if you don't find that tomb soon, you're fired.
Luckily, a few days later, November 1922, Carter found Tutankhamun's tomb.
Thank goodness for that, I was worried.
Lord Caneron was there when Howard Carter broke through the tomb wall and through a tiny little hole was able to look inside.
Carter, can you see anything?
No.
Why not?
Because your head is in the way.
I'm sorry. Have another look. Carter, can you see anything?
Yes, I can see wonderful things. We found the first intact Egypt tomb ever. All the treasure is still there.
We learned a lot about Egypt and Egyptians. Thanks to Howard Carter.
And you can still see Tutankhamun's body in Cairo Museum today.
This year has been so incredibly dull.
I know, right? 2020 and 2021, the years of COVID.
Yes, I have been afraid to cough in public for months now. I am so pleased that the restrictions seem to be easing off. How lovely it is that we can finally hug our family and visit them indoors.
Are you going away this summer holiday?
Oh yes, we are going to Romania. Get it? Romania? Ha ha ha.
Yes, my mum and dad have said we are going on the first plane out of here as soon as the summer holidays begin.
I have an idea. Why don't we go on a trip around the world?
This term we have been learning about wonders of the world, Romans and the Great Fire of London and the seaside. I'd love to go and visit some of those locations.
Okay, let's get packing.
Oh
We're going where the sun shines brightly. We're going where the sea is blue. We've seen it in the movies. Now let's see if it's true.
First up is the room.
We have been learning about the Romans and history stuff. So I know so much about the Romans.
The Romans conquered the great seal of Europe, North Africa and the Middle East. This was known as the Roman Empire. They even conquered some of Britannia, which we now know as Britain today.
Look at all your materials we made. They're originally made from wood and metal.
The ancient Romans worshipped a lot of different gods and goddesses, and each god and goddess had its specialty. Venus was worshipped if you had a problem in love. And Mars is the god of war.
Did you know the Romans invented toilet paper?
They used a wet sponge on the end of a stick.
Ew, gross, that's too much information.
Well, that sounds easy to make the toilet paper today.
The Romans loved to watch gladiator battles. In fact, they enjoyed them so much that they built the Colosseum in Rome to watch gladiators fighting wild animals and ship naval battles.
They furthered the Colosseum for the sea battles.
The Colosseum is the largest amphitheatre in the world.
That is why it is one of the seven new wonders of the world. Remember we learned about the wonders in geography?
What are the new wonders of the world?
The Great Wall of China, Christ the Redeemer, Chichen Itza, Machu Picchu, Petra, and the Taj Mahal.
And to get one. Next stop, Rio de Janeiro, Brazil.
Please, let's go and see Christ the Redeemer statue. Being Catholic, this statue is so significant and important.
It's symbolic of Jesus dying on the cross to save Christians.
The Christ statue protects the environment like a roof over your head.
After all of this travelling around, I could do with some relaxing time out. This is our summer holiday, after all.
Let's hit the beach. I could do some cursing and turning on the soft sand.
Are there any beaches in Rio we could go to?
Yes, Coco Cabana is magnificent and extends for 4 kilometres with a flurry of activity.
You are bound to find so many tourists at kiosks. Five other kids showing off their soccer skills and beach vendors shouting out their words among the rain on the beach.
Next up, London, United Kingdom.
Well, we can hit the beach as soon as we get home.
That's a fabulous idea. Where shall we go?
Brighton, to collect a few pebbles.
Blackpool is famous for their dog ride, which reminds me of how we learnt about past and present seaside locations in geography.
Can you believe that they used to go to the beach fully clothed and long attire?
That would make me far too hot and sweaty.
Ew!
I am so sorry, Bobby. I'm landing at London Heathrow.
Oh no, I don't think I have time for that.
My mum doesn't even know I left the country, let alone winter. I can be grounded for the whole summer.
I am happy to go to London. I have loved learning about the Great Fire of London. It has been fascinating.
It's a good job that Samuel Pepys kept his diary, otherwise we would have not have known anything about the Great Fire.
It's amazing. I so enjoyed how it changed as a result of the Great Fire.
To think St. Paul's Cathedral had to be rebuilt after the fire. I must say, I do quite like how it looks now.
And they didn't even have firefighters. Imagine using a leather bucket, a fire squatter and a hook to put out fire.
Poor Thomas Farney, he might have felt dreadful if a fire started in his bakery.
I really like that a monument was erected to remind us of the Great Fire.
Yes, it stands at the junction of Parliament Street and the Fish Hill and near Penningnight, where the Great Fire started.
It started on 2nd September 1666. Wow, history's interesting. We learnt so much from the past.
Speaking of which, can you believe we're coming to the end of our time in the Nicholas Owen block?
Oh, this has been a lovely tour, but I think we better head back to school for our prize giving.
Well, you better board the train and I'm off duty.
Quick, let's get our tickets.
I've had so many fun memories in Nicholas Owen block.
We were all in nursery together.
Mrs. Waters is so fun, kind, friendly and caring.
I remember we used to count every morning.
We learned all our phonics in nursery.
We all joined in reception together.
Miss Pell Harper is so wise, funny and fantastic.
I remember learning about money in reception. Miss Pell Harper also had the guinea pigs.
Oh, and in blending, yes, Miss Norton.
Mrs. Norton was so kind, caring, joyful and great at drawing.
Miss Carver was very kind, smart and always smiling.
In bed, like, I was so excited to wear my new uniform for the first time.
We joined SJB at the start of Blandike.
And then we moved to Berkman.
We joined SJB in Bertman's.
My favourite part of year two has been collecting ties for the first time.
I love making shields and learning about the Romans. We learned how to make long stories in Bertman's.
I think that one of my favourite times this year was coming back to school to see my friends and teachers.
It really makes me appreciate how lucky I am to have such lovely friends, teachers, and such an incredible school to go to.
And how exciting it is to embark about our new journey to the middle school.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you all very much for zooming in on your amazing boys and watching and taking part really in the end of term celebrations. We are obviously very sorry that you couldn't have all been here in person. However, I hope this way you've been able to see all the incredible things your sons have achieved over the year, but also seen how well they are as a group, all together, loving each other's company, which of course has been the main aim for a lot of your boys this year. We'd like to thank everybody hugely for their help with being able to create this little film for you of your boys' achievements, particularly the music department, Mr. Jones and Dr. Mollison, who have worked endlessly to enable us to be able to produce this for you all. The staff, your boys' teachers, who have worked so hard to make sure that your sons have stayed happy, stayed safe, and been able to be a part of the school community every day, has been just an amazing, amazing thing to see. But ultimately, we want to thank your sons for keeping their spirits up, for having such great humour, and making sure we as teachers are able to do the job as best we can because of their incredible ability to adapt. We'd like to thank you all so much for everything that you've helped us do this year and be a part of our community one way or another. I'm wishing you all a really happy and safe summer holiday. I'm really looking forward to welcoming you back in September for, yes, maybe new adventures, but they're going to be fantastic ones with all of you and all of us together. Take care and have a lovely summer. Bye-bye.